Hey Mathli. Hey Aryan.
Hi.
Do you remember the story of Saint Kuryakos alias Chavra that our teachers told us?
Yes, Arshia, we do.
Are there any other saints from India?
Of course, Arshia. Haven't you heard of Saint Euphrasia from Kerala?
I think I've heard. Could you both tell me more about her?
Being a Flarite, it is very important for you to know about Saint Euphrasia, the Praying Mother. Saint Euphrasia was born as Rosa Elua Tindal on 17th October 1877 in a village called Kattur in Kerala. Rosa was the eldest child of a wealthy landowner, Cherupu Karan Antony, and his wife, Kunjati, a virtuous woman.
Rosa inherited a precious gift from her mother, the spirit of prayer and her deep devotion to Blessed Mother Mary. Rosa was blessed with the rare joy of offering herself for the Lord. She found immense happiness during her prayers.
As she grew older, Rosa wanted to enter the Sisters of the Mother of Carmel. Her father opposed this. He wanted to arrange a marriage for her with the son of another prosperous family in the region. Seeing her resolve, her father eventually relented and accompanied her to the convent.
In the convent, she was taught Malayalam, English, maths and music. They were also given training in drawing and handicrafts. Rosa had a special talent for needlework and her skills were appreciated by everyone.
Rosa's life was full of trials and she tried very hard to overcome them. She fell sick very often and the authorities decided that she did not have the health to continue staying at the boarding school.
In 1889, she had a severe attack. She was almost on the verge of dying. Then suddenly, Rosa had a vision of the Holy Family standing in front of her. They even told her that she was going to lead a long life as a nun and that she would die only when she gets old. It was indeed a miracle that Rosa was fine immediately and stayed in boarding for a long time till she completed her studies.
In 1897, the first native bishop established a Carmelite convent in Ambarakad. Rosa, along with all her five inmates, was brought to the Carmelite convent. Rosa was received as a postulant, taking the name of Sister Euphrasia of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Rosa's dream at last came true. Sister Euphrasia completely surrendered herself to Lord Jesus.
The superiors recognized the striking qualities and virtues of Saint Euphrasia and acknowledged her discipline and exemplary life. She was appointed novice mistress of the congregation. She held this position for 9 years until 1930, when she was made Mother Superior of the convent, where she was to live the rest of her life, serving as Mother Superior until 1916.
She endeavored to lead a life of constant prayer and of devotion to the Sacred Heart of Jesus, becoming known to many people as the Praying Mother. Saint Euphrasia spent much of her day in the convent chapel, to which she had a strong devotion. Saint Euphrasia died on 29th August 1952 at Mary's Convent. Her tomb has become a pilgrimage site, as miracles have been reported by some of the faithful.
So Arshia, we believe now you know more about Saint Euphrasia and the faithful life she led to serve Lord Jesus.
Yes, Mathli and Aryan, now I know how wonderful Saint Euphrasia was.
Saint Euphrasia is an inspiration for us to follow the path of discipline and of virtues.
Bye.
जग में सबकी सेवा कर, कष्ट और पीड़ा सही पर यही लगन थी उम्र भर, यही लगन थी उम्र भर। मैं हूँ प्रभु की, प्रभु है मेरे, ऐसी है प्रियतम
thank you.